President Yoweri Museveni plans to meet cultural leaders next month to share the NRM vision. He made the remarks yesterday while meeting a group of cultural leaders led by Jude Mike Mudoma, the Umkuka III of Bama Sabah Culturing Station. During the meeting at State House Entebbe, the president implored cultural leaders to sensitize their people on wealth creation and enhance their livelihoods.
Prosperity will come from wealth creation. That's why you hear His Highness here talking of the money we are sending to the villages to deal with wealth creation of every homestead. We say every homestead must be involved in wealth creation, producing a good or a service and selling it. Now, if you say that's the way to get prosperity,
he noted that when people produce more, they will realize that the local market is not enough, thus the need for the African market. President Museveni also cautioned the leaders against the politics of dividing people based on tribes, saying that it hinders development.
We tell our people, please, you people, the tribe is important, but love Uganda. Why? Because you need it. You need it for your own prosperity. If you want prosperity, please don't forget Uganda. You can have your tribe, but Uganda is the one which will help you to be prosperous more easily. Love Uganda, love Africa, socio-economic transformation.
The Umkuka expressed gratitude to President Yoweri Museveni for the unwavering support towards Bugisu sub-region. He also thanked him for developing the country through various initiatives like the Parish Development Model. His Royal Highness Tugbui Amenya Fiti V, the President of the Forum of Kings, Queens and Traditional Leaders in Africa, also the Paramount Chief of Aflao Traditional Area in Ghana, thanked President Museveni for his spirit of Pan-Africanism and solidarity.
Your Excellency, your commitment to Pan-Africanism is not just a political stance, but a deeply held belief that has shaped your leadership and vision for our country. You have consistently championed the cause of African unity, independence, and self-reliance, emphasizing the importance of solidarity among African nations.
To allow for government-aided schools in Barra City have received 4,956 textbooks for learners and teachers' guides to ease their learning and teaching. Secondary schools received 2,779 textbooks in 61 categories, and primary schools got 2,177 books in 17 categories.
Over 17 categories. The secondary schools have over 61 categories of the consignment in here. The summary of the numbers for books going to primary schools are 2,177. The books going to secondary schools are 2,779. That brings us to 4,956 textbooks here.
The schools include Mbara Army Secondary School, St. Paul Secondary School, Mbara Secondary School, Lekatojo Primary School, St. Mary's Primary School, and Kabamba Primary School, all in Mbara City. Rita Achukwasa Bwahika, the woman MP for Mbara City, while handing over the textbooks to the Mbara City Education Department, said that books that were donated to secondary schools are for now the new lower secondary curriculum.
The estimate of the amount of money that we are talking about in this consignment is about 67,102,000 shillings.
Atikwasa said the textbooks will require teachers to intensively engage learners with learning aids and teachers' guides. Edith Namusoke, the inspector for schools in Barra City, appreciated the efforts exhibited by Atikwasa to boost the education sector in Barra City.
They have reference books. Our teachers did not have reference books, but now she has provided them.
Atikwasa said the whole consignment of books cost 67 million shillings. The National Unity Platform has launched an online registration system to enable people register themselves as members at their convenience. David Louis Rubongoya, the NUP Secretary General, said that the innovation will mostly help people in diaspora who may not be close to the physical registration points.
This system is going to enable us, first of all, for you to be able to register yourself online on your phone, on your computer, or any other gadget. But number two, to check your membership registration status. Once we get data from the field, we enter it into the system, and then people are able to check whether indeed they are registered or not. And those who are already registered can check their membership, but also those who wish to be registered will be able to be registered through this platform.
While launching the URL of the platform, Rubongoya said that the system will enable the members to know their registration status. He added that the NUP National Executive Committee decided to make the registration free for those who cannot afford the 1,000 shillings registration fee.